Gotta like it when the sun's out. Always makes you feel good. Anyway, it's 3:55, another day. I ended up doing what Jess Hogan told me to do is I couldn't break this loose from that rim, and I'll show you why. But I put two pieces of wood right here and a big C-clamp and pushed it together. And I let that tire lube just soak in there and soak in there and soak in there. Let me see some light. Well, this is why it was so hard to come up. This rim is brand new. Okay, look what's on the tire. That's all chrome. Let me put you up in front of the light. Okay. That is all little pieces of chrome. That was pretty much bonded to... The tire is brand new too. And you could tell that there was never sealed or patched or anything. Actually, look down under. That's all chrome. See that? I can't find the manufacturer. But I know I got it in 05. It was manufactured 10/29/01. It was a display model. I bought it off eBay, 140, 450. I cannot find the manufacturer. But I pretty much know it's Hong Kong Fui. Because I put this tire on this rim because I already told you that story that CC Cycle in town bent my rim and wouldn't take responsibility. But anyway, so I mount my own. And it's always easier to have three spoons. Because when you put one spoon in and another spoon, sometimes you got to pull the spoon out to get it to break. If you have three spoons, it's a lot easier. Anyway, this was not like this. No. Not at all. And it was pretty much just bonded to it. It's just basically cheap chrome. So, I noticed on this rim it's got little grooves in the chrome, in the metal. I guess that would, maybe I'm wrong, but I would think that would help the tire seat. Basically, I got a sandblast inside too. Because if I put this tire back on and never have to change it, it's going to be a nightmare. Yeah, I had to pull that bell stem out and sandblast this rascal down. The odd thing is I don't know, maybe this is not the same manufacturer of the rim, because I'm believing this is not chrome plated. I could be wrong, I don't know. But I'm going to put... Tick, 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 tick. Well, I don't know what day it is really, but I guess it don't matter. But this is what I woke up to. Here you go, a lot of drifting. Winter Wonderland. Okay. What have I been doing? Cleaning all the little chrome stuff. I ain't got it all done. The reason I've been cleaning it to see what needs to be absolutely needs to be re-chromed and what doesn't. That does. That's pretty heavy. Yeah. I haven't even got to the motor. I believe I did all the forks. I realize that there's a lot of moisture in there. You know, I mean, didn't dawn on me. So what I did is we had in the basement, we use it in the basement to pull humidity out, water, moisture, because it creates rust. I know this chrome is gonna get all dusty, but I don't want to wait till the last minute to get stuff chrome plated. This is an old school dehumidifier, but it still works. That's, I guess, what you know would be laying on something in here. Not all of it would be laying on my bike, but some of it would be. Oh, let me see. Got some questions. Yeah. Okay, where do I start? I needed a... Oh, this stuff, they think is gold, man. This is $18. But, buy what you gotta buy. Pause my brake thing up. This stuff takes a lot of Q-tips. A lot of Q-tips. Yeah. Where am I at? Oh, right here. This is a 7mm. They don't make a pike focus. They don't make a pike or a chrome acorn for a 7mm because it's oddball. This is what a pike is. So I'm taking a quarter 20, and it took me a while to find a 1/15/64 drill bit. So I got another pike I'm gonna drill and then I'm gonna tap. Well, couldn't find a tap in town, 7mm. 7mm's oddball, I guess. So I ordered off the net. I wanted to ask you, Just Hogging. You know, I like internal throttles and all that. I'm just trying to keep, this is what I got into it. 16.2. Thought I had more. But you have to deduct the rim of the rim I sold and things like that. But anyway, trying to keep this under 19.5. We'll see. This is fine, but I was wondering, this is a front brake reservoir. I don't even know what to look for. I want something that bends real sharp, goes down about 2 inches, bends real sharp in a 90, so I can run it through here. That's what I'm looking for. Don't really know where to start. Okay, what else we got on the agenda? Yeah, old school air filter system, because I smoke cigarettes a lot and the ceiling get yellow. Anyway, my Arlen Ness. Let me turn some light on. My Arlen Ness headlight. She's got her share of pits in it. Probably gonna have it chrome plated. My brake rotor, I hogged it out. It fits pretty good now. I use a plasma cutter to cut it, and then I ground it with a, I don't know what it's called. Anyway, this is the front of the Arlen Ness headlight, pitted. You know, I can't really complain because a lot of this stuff has been set in moisture for a long time. It's kind of hard when you, it takes a lot of time, put that way, when you clean down in there. Because if you don't, that stuff will creep around the corner of this stuff that shows. I learned the difference between show chrome. Show chrome is like a show car. If, you know, if when you paint somebody's car, they don't want no dirt in it. Well, chrome is like that. Sometimes you have to do it 3 or 4 times to strip it again, make sure there's no imperfections on it. When you get show chrome, it's very pricey. Anyway, my front rim, couldn't sandblast down, so I dropped it off. Oh, the piece of paper ain't out here. Anyway, it cost me $100, maybe it is. Yeah. It'll be done a week from now. This is just to strip it. No, that's a different thing. Anyway, it's a place that Todd does chrome plating. He can't chrome plate my rim because aluminum and steel is a different process, the way I understand. But he can strip the rim, the front rim. To strip it is $100. I tried sandblasting it, and it wasn't going to happen. I'm here to tell you, it wasn't going to happen. Oh, I picked up a new sign. That was cute. Here's a shop in town, a small shop that's been around. I couldn't beat the, really. How about Focus? Used? What am I gonna do with it? Not sure yet. Oh, there you go. Just a big old snowflake. You like that? Yeah. It looks like one of those things in when you're a kid and you shake, and it looks like it's snowing in a ball. Yeah, that's what it reminds me of because it's going so fast. Anyway, it's kind of funny. Well, I'm rambling on. I'm waiting. There's two people that wanted to be in an auction. Apologize for not doing the auction yet because there's two people that wanted to be in it. And I said I would wait because I don't know. Because I'm trying to gather all the money I can for Just Hogging, so I'll throw some money in the kitty or whatever to get him to come down here to help me work on my bike or babysit me. This is not real. I can do the mechanics, but I'm not real confident. And I'd rather just have a babysitter. But my point is, I'm waiting on. I'm not going to say their names. Hopefully, this Friday, I will do the auction because there's two people sending money. Kind of need the space case right now. I don't know why. Oh, I was going to tell you a story. Commercial break. Where's my coffee? Yeah, commercial break. When I was a kid, you guys ever get like socks for Christmas? I remember I used to get socks for Christmas and I'm thinking that's some bullshit. I used to hate it. Hate it a lot. It's funny how life changes. I used to think I would get ripped off. Not that all I got was socks, but I got other toys. But I just thought, you take that money that my mom bought socks with, gave to me for Christmas, which are the toys, that they could have bought me more toys. Not that I didn't get a lot of toys. The point is, I used to say, fuck that socks. Well, yesterday I just dropped $36 on socks. Oh yeah, socks are good. It's funny how you think one thing when you're younger, and you think something else when you're older. But good socks are priceless, man. For me, for an old man like me, it's priceless. What else we got? I think that's about pretty much a wrap. Pretty sure. I'm sure after I turn the video camera off, I will remember what else I wanted to spit out. I see other people are starting to see what I was talking about YouTube screwed shit up. Because when somebody makes a comment on my video, I have to go and look for on my video for the comment. It's changed a lot. They screwed it up. I couldn't believe I couldn't find a... Well, this ain't even it. It's another one. I've learned to keep sales receipts. Oh, here's another one. On these socks that I bought, they were like $3.50 a pair. Yeah, I know. I can't believe I spent $3.50 for a pair, but when your feet don't get cold and they don't get wet and they feel gushy, it's fucking priceless. But here's my point. It says a year warranty on it if you keep the sales receipt. So what I did this time, because those socks ain't gonna last a year. Not on my feet. I put the box up in my bedroom with the sales receipt, and after they get holes in them from, they say they'll last a year, craftsmanship, I'm calling them. I say, hey, want me to take a picture of these socks, man? Because you said a warranty for a year. Either you're fucking, you're standing by your warranty or you're fucking bullshit. One or the other. They said it. You know? You can buy bulk of socks. You know what I hate about socks? Here you go. Here's socks. I hate socks. Here's your leg. And here's where your foot bent. And if you're, the heel and the toe isn't fit for your foot, you get these, all these little wrinkles right here. And they slide down. I fucking irritate. I get so irritated. Anyway. Oh, I do have to do this today. Because I tagged my shin. I did pull the tires back all the way. Here's a pretty simple process. Just slid this back. So I only got one U-bolt to hold it. So I can still get it around. But this thing right here. You see that little nut right there? That little rascal right there. There we go. Just use the longest bolt you can find, Tom. I hit my shin on it. Because it's like a roll of size. Every time I walk over there to the toolbox. So I'm cutting that off and I gotta make a plate to put it back on. This is actually a tilt bed trailer. This is actually an old Sea-Doo trailer that I picked up. And I modified it. It's kind of, it's hairy. Get it up there, I'll tell you. But anyway, that's what that pin's for. And I made all this right here, so, you know, so it holds the tire and it tilts. Ugh. So this used to be like concave down through here. And you could tell where I welded that in, that center brace in, welded all this in. Like I said, it used to be concave right here for a Sea-Doo trailer. Because I figured I could kill two birds with one stone instead of buying a lift or a bike. Because I thought if I ever have a problem with mechanics or anything, I need to trailer it. It'd be nice to have a trailer, so I use a trailer as a lift. Anyway, I got some stuff off eBay. $20. It's a 5/8 twisted chrome. It needs to be re-chromed, but it's really hard sometimes to find. See, what I like is a twist goes that way, and a twist goes the opposite. I like that. Unlike this sissy bar, which I'm not going to complain. I paid $70 for it, and it's a half-inch twist chrome. But the chrome is nice. I can't complain. You can tell it's the mid-70s. The story was the guy's uncle is poor in health, and he had a bunch of stuff for sale, and yeah. Anyway, what I don't like is you can tell the difference between manufacturers. See how the chrome twists that way and this chrome twists this way? The nicer ones in my eyes, the sissy bars, the chrome will twist this way and will chrome the opposite way. See how this goes up? They would go opposite this way. Anyway, what am I going to do today? I don't know. I'm going, that's why I'm going to cut that thing off in the front so I don't take my shin on it again. Yeah, that always feels really nice when you take your shin on it. It's like doing a little Robosize. Yeah. And went and bought, from Dollar Store, went and bought some serving trays so I can separate my stuff. Well, I did pick up some cool stuff recently. And then I'll kill this. Where'd my cigarette go? There you go. Can't talk without a cigarette. guy down the road that I snowblow for, because he is not too old to snowblow, but, you know, his lungs and stuff can't handle the cold weather. But anyway, he was mentioned the other day that he had stuff in his garage that, you know, if I was interested in buying, he would sell to me. I'm like, okay. You know, he's on a fixed income. But I gotta say, he buys good tools. He used to. We're all gonna get old and not be able to do stuff. That's why I snowblow for him. But anyway, I looked at these. It's a variable speed. Lay it down on the floor, will you, Tom? Rotor tool. I just thought, you know, $10. No, I didn't think I could beat that. This got a little light you can put on it. I'm sure the battery is out of control, crazy price. He does have a Porter Cable mini compressor. It's a pancake one I thought about purchasing, but I had to do some research to see how much it is. But he sold me this too for $45. And what am I gonna do with it? I don't know. Oh, you like that? See, this is what happens when you got one eave under one eave, and then you got one eave over the other eave, because your property isn't big enough. Because if I push this over, it would suck up room there, and I need it anyway. So this is what you get. This is why when I used to spray cars, snowflakes would come in. I've had it done. Anyway, I'm getting sidetracked. Here's all my metal getting rusty. What was my point? The point is, I came out. Oh, these are like anywhere from $200 to $300. It is a 16-foot, 4-section, click click. He sold it to me for $45. Hopefully this weekend it'll be up for auction. Well, I mean, if the other money comes, whatever, it will. Anyway, I think I love it. People in Arizona and Texas and Florida, this stuff gets old. There you go, see it? Like the snow just blowing. Okay then, there you go. I'm balling on a budget, I guess, huh? And when the big dogs get all done eating, even the puppies get a piece of something, motherfucker. Don't forget this. You gotta put that little small stuff in the air, you know? Anyway.